Let's learn layered architecture. What is layered architecture? Layered architecture is a software design pattern that organizes a system into distinct layers, each with specific responsibilities and roles. This architectural style promotes separation of concerns, making it easier to develop, maintain, and scale applications. Each layer communicates only with adjacent layer, which helps to isolate changes and simplifies debugging and testing. So we have different layers. Layer can communicate with the adjacent layer. Let's see the key characteristics of this architecture. Okay, separation of concerns. Each layer addresses a specific aspect of the application, allowing developers to focus on one area at a time without affecting others. Defined responsibilities. Layers are designed with clear responsibilities, which helps streamline development and enhance code readability. Encapsulation. Each layer encapsulates its functionality and exposes a well-defined interface for interaction with other layers. Interlayer communication. Layers typically communicate with one another through functions calls or service requests, promoting a structured flow of data and control. Now let's see those layers in the layered architecture. I mean, what are those layers? Okay, now it will make more sense. So those layers are presentation layer. And the responsibility of presentation layer is this layer handles user interactions and presents data to the user. It typically includes user interface elements and input validation. And the technologies used for this layer are HTML, CSS, JavaScript framework like React, Angular, or Vue.js. So whenever we open any website in any of the browser, the very first thing what we see, it's an HTML page where we have all the user experience, whether it's some CTA button interaction, web pages, form submission, form container, etc. Everything is presentation layer through which user interacts with the system. Then we have business logic layer, or we call it as domain layer. Responsibilities are it contains the core functionality of the application, implementing business rules and logic. It processes inputs from the presentation layer and interacts with the data layer. Technologies would be any programming language, popular languages, for example, Java, C Sharp, Python, etc. We have so many, right? And frameworks would be, and there are multiple frameworks, whether it's a CMS1, Spring framework, .NET. So there are many frameworks available. So once the user is submitting any form, for example, and then some business logic is being executed, whether we are saving this data to any database system, or we are sending this data to any third party system, or maybe we are doing some validation against this data, we are pulling some data from any downstream APIs, right? Everything, whatever logic is written in backend, that logic comes in business logic layer, right? Only the logic, not the how we are persisting, where we are persisting this data, because that will go to another layer, right? So these layers are actually interrelated, they interact with each other, right? Next to one, the adjacent layer. So for example, presentation layer, adjacent layer is business logic layer. So presentation layer will talk to business logic layer. It will not directly communicate to third layer, which is data access layer. So presentation layer will not communicate with data access layer directly, but will communicate via business logic layer, right? Now comes the third layer, which is data access layer. And the responsibility of this layer is it manages database interactions, including CRUD operation. CRUD operation is creation of something, reading some data, updating some data, delete. So it's just like first letters we have taken, C, R, U, D, CRUD operations. This layer abstracts data storage and retrieval from the business logic. So this layer abstracts data storage, right? So data that info detail, it's not a low level, just high level. So it's hide that information. Technologies used, all those database related key terms, SQL database, whether it's MySQL, PostgreSQL, ORM related tools, Hibernate, etc. Right? Then we have database layer. So with this layer, database access layer, we are accessing the database, right? But database itself is a layer here. So responsibility will include that the physical storage layer where the data is stored and managed. This layer is usually managed by a database management system, DBMS, and technologies will include, of course, the MySQL, Oracle, MongoDB, any database, right? So we have presentation layer. The user will interact with this layer. Then once this any event is happening, the business logic will take care of that logic. Will interact with the third layer, which is data access layer. What is the logic behind this? How we are going to interact with that data? How we are going to access that data? And then the database layer, where we actually put the data, will store that data, right? So that is database layer. So let's see the advantages of layered architecture. Okay, maintainability. Changes in one layer typically do not affect others, making it easier to manage and update the system. What does that mean? So for example, we have those four layers: presentation layer, we have business logic layer, we have data access layer, we have database layer. So these four layers, right? Consider we need a change that we want to change some user experience. We have those buttons which are in blue in color, we want to change them to light blue, or maybe something else, maybe red in color, right? What we will do? We will change the CSS, we will change the style, we will change the theme, and this will impact only the presentation layer. We will maybe change the HTML. Whatever changes we are going to do, it will just impact the presentation layer. We will not change the business logic. We will not change the database operation, database access. We will not change that. So maintainability is easy because we are just changing, we are just updating, we are just concentrating on one layer, right? Reusability. Layers can often be reused across different applications, particularly the data access layer and business logic layer. And let's understand this also. So for example, we have business logic layer, and this business logic is pulling some user profile information, right? So we have data access layer and database. Business logic layer is actually hitting the data access layer and pulling some user profile information. And we have a presentation layer. Presentation layer is just using this data. Now consider we have another application for the same enterprise solution, but this time the presentation layer is changed, but we want to pull in the same profile information. Do we need another business logic layer? Do we need another data access layer? Do we need another database layer? No, we don't, because we want the same type of profile information, but just the UI is changed. So what we'll do, we'll create a new presentation layer, and we will reuse the existing data access layer, existing business logic layer, existing database layer. So that's why the reusability factor is increased here. Scalability factor. Each layer can be scaled independently. For example, if the presentation layer experiences high traffic, it can be scaled without impacting the other layers. And that makes sense also. And it is applicable for database layer, data access layer as well. Consider a scenario where we need more replica of the database. We can create multiple replicas of the database system, and then we can scale it, right? So scalability is also a factor. Testability. Individual layers can be tested separately, simplifying unit testing and integration testing. Now there might be a question: without the database access layer or data access layer or business logic layer, how can we test, for example, front end? We cannot validate. So partially true, partially not true, because consider a scenario where we have the presentation layer, right? And within the presentation layer, we have static pages, we have dynamic pages, right? So we can validate the static pages, you look and feel. We can still check, test the even the dynamic pages, look and feel, we can validate if the user experience is good or not, right? For example, we want to validate if once the user is clicking on any of the form container, and as per user experience, user should land on a thank you page screen, right? We can still validate it because we have that page available on our front end. So testability is easy. We can test individual layers without any issue. Now let's see the disadvantages of this architecture. Performance overhead. The separation into layers can introduce performance bottlenecks due to the additional processing required for inter-layer communication. What does that mean? So because we have different layers, so for example, presentation layer is one, business logic is maybe on another platform altogether, right? Maybe we have a middleware in between where we have put all the business logic at middleware. It's totally different technology altogether, and through APIs we are connecting to middleware, right? Now, because we are on the network, these calls are happening on over network, there will be of course a latency. That is what it is about, performance overhead, because we have separated these layers, and then the interaction, the interface will happen over network. There will always be a performance latency. Complexity. While layers help manage complexity, they can also introduce it, especially if the number of layers becomes excessive or if there are many dependencies between them. Rigidity. Strict layering can lead to inflexibility in certain cases where cross-layer interaction becomes cumbersome and necessary complex solution. So I mean, this might become a complex solution if we have different systems also. So consider a scenario where, like I said, business logic is written on maybe a middleware solution we have written, right? And then we have multiple systems. Through this middleware, we need to interact with these multiple systems, right? So as many systems we are integrating with our application, there will be more complexity because of course these are different distributed systems, right? So that way, these are the, not I would say disadvantages, but the architecture of the system will become more complex. Now let's see the use cases of layered architecture. So it can be used in web applications where the presentation layer needs to interact with business logic and data layer. That is one use case. Enterprise applications, large scale systems that require clear separation of functionality and maintainability. Mobile applications to manage different aspects like UI, business logic and data handling separately. And to be told, most of the enterprise solutions right now are built on this architecture, layered architecture. And I have mentioned it earlier also, it is not fixed that we always use one architecture principle. We always use tailored one, the combination of different flavors, the good features of different architectures. So for example, we might have a layered architecture, and then within layered architecture we can also have microservices architecture or event driven architecture or a combination of layered plus event driven plus microservice. So that is possible. So based on business experience, business needs, based on how can we make it more performative, what kind of solution we are building, we decide that which architecture's capability we should pull in and to make it as a tailored architecture. So that is always done like that only. So let's conclude layered architecture. Layered architecture provides a structured approach to software design, facilitating separation of concerns and promoting maintainability and scalability. By organizing an application into distinct layers, developers can focus on specific functionalities and manage complex more effectively. For example, front-end developers, they will only concentrate on the front-end layer. They will work on HTML, CSS, theme, design, whereas the back-end developer will only concentrate on the business logic layer. Whereas a database developer will only concentrate on the database access layer, right? However, careful consideration is required to balance the benefit of layering with potential performance impact with architectural rigidity. Like I said, because layers are separated and interaction or interface will have over network, so of course there will be a performance impact that we need to compensate. I mean, we'll see how can we, you know, reduce that performance impact, how can we reduce that latency, how can we scale this backend, these backend APIs performance. That we need to consider while we will design the architecture of such solution.